So this is Angela Skurtu with St. Louis Marriage Therapy. My website is www.therapistinst.louis.com. And I'm in the bedroom today, changing up the scenery, because I am a sex therapist, and I do come to help you in the bedroom. Not in your bedroom. So by the way, I don't go in anybody's bedrooms, but figuratively, I talk to people about what to do in their bedrooms. So today, I would like to talk to you about how to create more erotic scenarios, dirty ways to start sex. Because I've learned that people are getting tired of the same old initiation styles. They have this real routine way of doing things that just makes them so bored. So a couple ideas I want to throw out there. One is starting with naked yoga. I don't know if you've heard of it, but some couples will be naked or partially naked, so you can be half naked, and put their yoga mats right up beside each other. Now, if you have kids, you would do this if the kids are asleep. If you have a room that you can lock, locks are helpful on doors, or if you know the kids are away, you know, somewhere at like a friend's house or at a parent's house, but you start your night out with some yoga that's about half naked or full naked. And part of how you create this into an erotic scenario is you're naked, but as you go through poses, you might stop whatever you're doing to go kiss your partner in a certain position. Or you might, like, and this is both ways. I'm not asking one partner to do all of the work. I'm saying either of you stop your practice for a moment, stand up, kiss your partner in a certain position. You know, there's the downward dog. Well, that's a beautiful place to rub someone's butt or to rub your hand sensually up and down their leg. Or kiss up their back, for example, on their spine. Now, all of the erogenous zones include places like the spine, really sensitive, thin skin places, like around the ears, the neck, places like this, the inside. So think of parts of your body that have thinner skin. Those are the pleasure zones. So that can be the inside of an elbow, can be underneath the knee, it can be at the ankle, right at the ankle. Anywhere where there's thin skin. So think of that and don't always go straight for genitals. I always tell people this because I think a lot of people are in a habit of going straight for genitals and they're missing out on all of the buildup. What I'm trying to create here for couples is ideas for how to build up energy and erotic excitement. So with naked yoga, that's one way of doing it is you're going through your poses and you're kissing a partner as they're in different poses or touching them sensually as they're in a pose. And so you can do this at the same time, or one person, if they're open to doing it while the other partner is rubbing them and touching them, can be the way that it's done too. So that's one erotic scenario. Another erotic scenario is any shower, bath, or hot tub, any form of water that you can get some privacy in. And again, it still has a similar look to it in that you are mostly nude or partially nude, because in a hot tub, you can have your swimsuit on. In a bath, I guess I would hope you were nude in a bath or a shower, but you can also, there can be a slowness to undressing. So this is an added erotic scenario, but slowly undressing a partner is part of that too. So not just getting naked right away, but taking it slow, slowly unveiling a shirt and kissing up the spine or kissing up the belly as somebody is taking off a shirt or, taking your tongue and tracing it up a trail, like men have kind of a trail of hair that kind of lines the middle of their belly and their chest. So like as you will take off a shirt, licking up that line, you know, or kissing different parts around the belly. When you slowly undo someone's pants, kind of kissing, don't go straight for genitals, but like that part for everybody, the corners essentially between the genitals and where the hips. It's like a really sensitive, wonderful place for people to kiss or to touch very sensually or softly. And so that can be something that's done. And thinking about these in water, so say you are already undressed, doing the same thing, like sensually bathing somebody and making sure you slowly go across each area and you're paying attention and not just washing it, but maybe kissing it right after or rubbing it close or even putting bodies next to each other and just rubbing and feeling those bodies up against each other. Those are all erotic scenarios that can start the process of sexuality. A lot of what I'm covering here is how to take things from I'm not quite there yet for sex to building into erotic tension and excitement. You don't have to want to have sex right in these moments to start to build an erotic excitement and tension. I think that's where a lot of my couples are having trouble, is when they're initiating, they're thinking, I need to go straight for sex. And if I'm not ready for sex, then I'm not ready for this. And a lot of good sex actually comes from these kind of tension building erotic scenarios that build you into sexual desire and interest. So I'm just putting that out there, that you don't have to feel a desire to have sex right in that moment to make the most of an action like this. All right, this is Angela Skurtu with St. Louis Marriage Therapy, and you can find me at www.therapistinst.louis.com. Thank you very much.